Learn how the new Azure Data Studio extension for Azure SQL migrations is making it easier for you to prepare and migrate to Azure SQL. This week on Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by Bjoern Peters, an MVP living all over the world. Bjoern, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Yeah, hi, Anna. Thank you for having me here. I'm in SQL Server since version 6.5. That's my first contact with SQL Server. Since then, I stepped through all the versions, mainly started my DBA session or DBA live with SQL Server 2008 or 2008 R2. And since then, stepped through 2012, 2014, and so on. And as Azure SQL started with Azure SQL databases in the cloud, I also jumped on that topic and loved to talk about and try everything around it and get to know those cool features, technology around Azure SQL, Azure SQL databases, or Azure SQL managed instances and all those stuff. And yeah, that's my journey.
Awesome. Yeah. And you're a big force in the community. So we're just excited to have you on the show. And today we're going to be talking about migrating your databases to Azure SQL and how preparation is everything. And I think specifically you're going to talk to us about how preparation is important, but also how we can make it easier. So can you tell us a little bit about what you've learned and how you approach migrations?
Yeah. In the early phases, we had the DMA, and or 10 years ago, we had just the opportunity to move databases from server to server by scripting everything or using PowerShell and doing everything by hand or manually. And then as the cloud steps further and comes more into the companies or in the public, as a public cloud service, we got tools from Microsoft like Data Migration Assistant. And that's the point where I wanted to start and show you the old word like Data Migration Assistant, and then how you can use the new technology which are provided by Microsoft right now and just shortly announced as GA, and how to make your life easier migrating databases or prepare for migration into the cloud much easier. So let me show you my screen. So the old database migration assistant, as most of us might know, is this great tool here. We can see we have the add source feature, and then we can connect to a SQL server on-prem or on your virtual machine, something like this. We have to choose the databases and add them to our assessment, it's checking the server, it's checking the databases, and we just get some information if that on-prem SQL server or that underlying databases are able to be moved into the cloud. For example, here into Azure Managed Instance. And you can see here, there's an unsupported feature on my SQL server here. This is provided by me, and I have to show you this. The migration issue database, as the name says, has a migration blocker. It has multiple log files. Just to make an easy failure for the migration blocker, just to show you. But this is everything we are getting from the old database migration assistant, And there's nothing more what we can get out of this tool. So one of the most main reasons or main questions we have in preparation to move databases into the cloud is not just, are my databases ready for the cloud, but which service or which performance class I have to provide in the database. As we know, on-prem or in a virtual environment, we have to set up our virtual machines with CPUs and RAM and disk performances and so on. And on-prem, it might be much easier to adjust by moving, for example, in VMware, the slider to increase the store, to increase the virtual memory on the machine. In the cloud, it's not that easy, but as it is still easy, but not that easy. So if we start deploying machines into the cloud, we have to guess a performance class. For example, if you deploy a Microsoft, if you deploy an Azure SQL managed instance, you can choose between several performance classes like cores, disk space, and so on. And but which one do you have to choose? This is the task of a new extension, or this new extension for Azure Data Studio makes your life much easier. The new Data Migration Assistant also has the feature inside, but it makes us it more easier to use it in our daily based tools like Azure Data Studio, which some of you already might use. So here we have the Azure Data Studio, and this is the starting point from a fresh Data Studio. We just click here on the extensions, and then we search for migration, which is the search phrase for the Azure SQL migration extension. This is shortly named as a GA tool, and it's released. So you can see, just click on the install button. It is installed immediately and doesn't take that much time. This extension allows you to do everything for the migration and the preparation from your Azure Data Studio. So as you can read here, there is the installation, how to do this, how to connect to your on-prem SQL Server or to your virtual machine. And then you get this cool feature here, assessment and SKU recommendation. So the new DMA and this extension are able to give you a recommendation on how to deploy your SQL Server or to deploy your databases into the cloud and to choose which performance class. Let me show you this in a demo. So on this note, I just installed the extension. Here you can see I have installed admin pack, Azure Arc, and so on. And here we have the Azure SQL migration extension. And then I have a connection to my virtual cluster here. And you can see here, I can manage everything from here. This is the normal behavior of Azure Data Studio. And through installation of the new extension, I have two new features here, SQL assessment and Azure SQL migration. And I can do a SQL Server assessment from my connection here. Just by clicking on the invoke assessment, it connects to the SQL Server and checks everything what is on my SQL Server. So this is a first overview of what might happen or what might occur during my assessment for the preparation or for the movement of my SQL Server or databases to the cloud. So you can see here some warnings, some information, which trace flags are enabled, and so on. And the main part, this is just for an overview, and you can take this overview for your daily base or for other assessments, for auditing, and so on, or inventory. But we want to talk about Azure SQL migration. So here you can see this is the migrate to Azure SQL feature or the overview. And by clicking on migrate to Azure SQL, we open a new window. You should start with start a new session, but as a preparation for this demo, I already selected this, or I just started some assessment, which takes some time, which extends here the demo session. So everything is prepared. You can see here, I already had some assessments done. And for example, you can click on those databases here, which you want to move into the cloud. Report server DBs, I don't need them in my cloud, as I might use, for example, Power BI online. So I just want to use the workload databases. Then you can see it's just checking again in my assessment here. As you can see here, we have just one of two databases which can be migrated. And you can find those information down here by clicking on View and Select. It shows you the errors or those blockers we have during the assessment. You can see here, we are not able to select the migration issue, which is correct. And by clicking on that migration issue database or on the name of that database, we can see why it is happening that we can't migrate this, or which is the migration blocker. And here you can see we have two transaction log files, which is not supported on a managed instance. And we can just click here on the demo DB. There is no issue, so I can select this. And then it will show me, for example, here, Azure SQL managed instance. And it provides me also a recommended configuration. It says, or recommends me a size Gen 5, general purpose, for virtual cores with 32 gigabytes of storage. Then I can click on the view detail, and it shows me some more information about how much CPUs are used, memory requirements, block storage, and so on, and what the assessment has gathered on information or data during my assessment time. Speaking about assessment time, you can start selecting, or if you do this initially, it will select data for at least 10 minutes. The longer you do this, the more information you will get. So, or the more accurate the recommendation will be. So if you do this on a fresh assessment, you have to run the assessment for at least 10 minutes. For example, you do it overnight or complete day, that's okay. And it will collect all those data from your local machine. And then you get those recommendations. You can adjust some parameters to your recommendation. If you want to have some buffer size or some spare CPU, for example, or more buffer in your compute power, then you can adjust all those parameters to be recognized in the recommendation. Here, for example, in the SQL Server on Azure Virtual Machine, you can have in my configuration during my assessment, you can see I should deploy a E2 ADS V5 machine with just two vCPUs. And as you might know, on Azure SQL virtual machines, we are able to adjust the storage configuration on the disk configuration for these virtual machines. We can find those information in the view detail button on the view. So we can see here, for example, SQL temp DB should be placed on the default D drive, which is the local fastest drive on your virtual machine. And we should add a P30 and for data files and another P30 for SQL transaction log files. And they write down all the overview or the recommendations, why on which data all those recommendations are based. So if we decide, for example, we go here on to a SQL Server virtual machine, because we want to deploy both databases into the cloud, we can select Next. And we will be asked to provide an Azure account, an Azure tenant, our subscription ID, location, where we want to deploy this. And you can see here, I can select my virtual machine. And then I will be asked in the next step how I want to migrate my databases. If I wanted to do it online to cut down the time of or the downtime for the migration phase, then I should choose online migration. And I have to provide a migration service, Azure Migration Service, in my Azure portal, or just using the offline migration, just to show you here. If I select offline migration, it gives me the opportunity to choose a storage account in Azure where I can do my backups do my backup to URL. For example, this ADS tool or this extension will do everything for me. And I have to provide the backup for this manually, and I can do this also by providing a source credential, do it on a backup on a local, then I have to copy it onto the blob storage, and everything can be done manually. If I want to do this in an online mode, you have to provide the local backup account or where you want to store your files, your backups on your local storage, or you can also provide here the blob container for the online migration with the migration service. And then we can choose here which migration service or where this migration service is located, which one we use here. I already provided one. And then I can click on the next button. It gives me a summarize of this migration phase. I have the destination server here in Azure. I perform an online migration via blob container in which subscription and so on. And then I can just start the migration. Yeah. And you can see here in the overview that we have one database migration in progress. And also in my portal, I can see I can monitor this progress or by clicking here on that button. You can see here it's running, it's ongoing, in which phase it is. And you can monitor the progress. This is how easy and how fast you can do an assessment for your SQL Server databases, how to migrate them into the cloud. So,
awesome. Thanks, Bjoern. This has been really interesting. I had seen the SKU recommender before, but it's pretty interesting to see how it actually works with your workload, with your databases. And I also hadn't seen how well DMA integrates into this Azure SQL migration extension. You know, as we kind of wrap up, are there any final tips and tricks you have for folks that might be just getting started with the Azure SQL migration extension?
Just give it a try. It's so easy, so self-explaining, and you don't have to be an expert in migration. You just install the extension, do an assessment. As I said, do it even longer than just 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, you will get a first guess. But if you have, for example, a data warehouse where you have nightly processing jobs or the data staging, data processing, you will get more accurate assessment data or recommendations if you do it overnight or even let it run for a week. No problem. Just give it a try. It's so easy.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Bjoern, for coming on the show. This is really great. I think I learned a lot. I'm sure our viewers learned a lot as well. To our viewers, check the description to get some links for learning more about Azure Data Studio and this great extension. And if you like this video, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what you think of the Azure SQL migration extension. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.